हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल मैड टाइम एकेडमी। मेरा नाम है अलमास एंड यू पीपल आर वाचिंग माय यूट्यूब चैनल वेयर आई विल बी अपलोडिंग वीडियोस फॉर एप्टीट्यूड क्लासेस फॉर ऑल कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम्स। इन दिस वीडियो लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न द कंप्लीट डिटेल्स अबाउट द टॉपिक्स गिवन बिलो एंड फॉर माई प्रीवियस रिलेटेड वीडियोज यू पीपल कैन चेक द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स वेयर आई हैव शेयर द लिंक ऑफ द प्ले लिस्ट। In this lecture, we are going to study about salary-based formulas. And my today's video lecture is to find the initial salary of a person. The second formula is if x percent of a quantity is deducted and the amount becomes rupees P, then the initial amount is given by P into 100 divided by 100 minus x. See, I will explain this to you people. See, suppose I have rupees A. This is the initial salary, and from the initial salary some x percent is getting deducted and it will become some rupees P. Now how to find the value of rupees A? That is nothing but the initial salary, which is given by P into 100 divided by 100 minus x. See, in the question they will give you the value of x percent and they will give you the value of rupees P, that is nothing but the present salary. Now, how to remember this formula very easily? See, from the initial salary, they are deducting some x percent one time. So, there is P into 100 in the numerator. That is nothing but 100 is multiplied with the present salary. And whereas in the denominator, it is 100 minus x. Why? Because from the initial salary, some quantity is getting deducted. Remember this one. I hope this is very clear. Let's see one example related to this formula. See, from the salary of Rahul, 20% is deducted as house rent. After this expenditure, he left with rupees 1377. His salary was. See, in the given question, Rahul's salary is deducted with 20%. That is nothing but x percent is equal to 20%, which is deducted. And after deduction, the salary will become 1377. That is nothing but present salary is equal to rupees 1377. Now we have to find his salary, which was, that is nothing but we have to find the initial salary, which is given by P into 100 divided by 100 minus x. We are using this formula because his salary is deducted and it is deducted once. Now we know the value of P and we have the value of x. Substitute this value in the given formula and solve them. You'll be getting the answer as initial salary is equal to present salary, that is 1377 into 100 upon 100 minus x. X ki jo value hai, that is 20. After solving this fraction, you'll be getting the answer as 1377 into 100 upon 100 minus 20 is 80. The answer is rupees 1721.25. Now this is the Rahul's initial salary. In this way you can solve the given problem. Let's see the next formula. See, if x percent of a quantity is taken, y percent of the remaining is taken by the second, and if the amount left is rupees P, then the amount at the beginning is given by P into 100 into 100 upon 100 minus x into 100 minus y. Let me explain this to you people. See, suppose rupees A is the initial salary and from the initial salary some x percent amount is deducted, and again from the reduced salary y percent is deducted, and rupees P is the amount which is left after deductions. Now how to find the value of rupees A? That is nothing but initial salary is given by P into 100 into 100 upon 100 minus x into 100 minus y. Now how to remember this formula very easily? See, from the initial salary, the deductions are made two times. So in the numerator, we have to multiply two hundreds. And whereas in the denominator, it is 100 minus x into 100 minus y. Why? Because once x percent is taken out from the initial salary and again y percent is taken from the initial salary. And since both the times some quantities are taken, so we'll be using the negative sign. I hope this concept is very clear to you people. Let's see one example related to this. See the example here. A man spends 5% of his money and then after spending 75% of the remainder had rupees 950 left with him. How much money had he at first? See here, suppose rupees A is the amount which a man had. And first he spends 5% of his amount, that is nothing but x percent. And again from the remained amount he spends 75%, that is y percent. And he is left with rupees 950, that is the present salary of a person, which is rupees 950. Now we have to calculate how much money had he at first, that is nothing but we have to calculate the initial salary. Now to find the initial salary, we will be using the formula, that is P into 100 into 100 upon 100 minus X into 100 minus Y. Why? Because both the time some quantities of deduction is made. As we know the values of P, X and Y, substitute in the given formula and solve it. You will be getting the answer as initial salary is equal to P ki jo value hai, that is 950 into 100 into 100 upon 100 minus 5 into 100 minus 75. After solving, 950 into 100 into 100 upon 100 minus 5 gives you 95. Into 100 minus 75 is 25. After solving this fraction, you'll be getting the answer as rupees 4000. This is the amount a man had at first. In this way, you can solve the given problem. See the next formula. If x percent of a quantity is taken by the first, y percent of the remaining is taken by the second, and the z percent of the remaining is taken by a third, and if the amount left is rupees P, then the amount at the beginning is given by P into 100 into 100 into 100 upon 100 minus x into 100 minus y into 100 minus z. See, let me explain this to you people. See, suppose I have rupees A as the initial salary and from the initial salary some x percent is deducted and again from the remained amount some y percent is taken out and again from the remained amount some z percent is taken and now a person is left with some rupees P, that is the present salary of a person. Now how to find the value of rupees A? That is nothing but the initial salary, which is given by P into 100 into 100 into 100. Why? Because from the initial salary, 3 times the deductions are made, divided by 100 minus X into 100 minus Y into 100 minus Z. Here in the denominator, there is 100 minus X minus y minus z. Why? Because from the initial salary all the 3 times some quantities are taken out. In this way you can remember the given formula. Let's see one example related to this formula. See, from a man's salary 10% is deducted on tax, 20% of the rest is spent on education and 25% of the rest is spent on food. After all these expenditures, he left with rupees 2700. Find his salary. See, suppose rupees A is the initial salary of man. Now, from the initial salary, 10% is deducted for tax. Again, from the remained amount, 20% is deducted for education. And again, from the remained amount, 25% is spent for food. Now, after all these expenditure, he is left with rupees 2700. That is nothing but present salary, which is given 2700 rupees. Now we have to find his salary was. That is nothing but we have to find the initial salary of a person. For this, we'll be using the formula, that is P into 100 into 100 into 100. Why? Because from the initial salary, three deductions are made. Divided by, in the denominator, it will be 100 minus X into 100 minus Y into 100 minus Z. Why? Because from the initial salary, three times the quantities are taken out. Since we know the value of P, X, Y and Z, substitute these values in the formula, we'll be getting the answer as initial salary is equal to P ki jo value hai, that is 2700 into 100 into 100 into 100 upon 100 minus 10, X ki jo value hai, that is 10, then into 100 minus 20, Y ki jo value hai, that is 20, into 100 minus 25. After solving this fraction, we will be getting the answer as rupees 5000. Now, this rupees 5000 is the initial salary of a person. In this way, you can solve the given problem.
I hope this video class was very helpful, and students, don't forget to like, share and subscribe if you just like this video, and hit the bell icon for my next video notification. And thank you so much for watching my video.